"Did you spend the night here?" she asked, in a voice that was totally devoid of all emotion. He nodded.
"I wasn't sure if the shop and house were locked, so I wanted to keep an eye on things for you. Besides, I couldn't leave without knowing."
"Mum is okay," she said quickly. Whatever Pete had done to her, he was still a friend to her family. "Dr. Adams says it was just exhaustion and stress. She was so busy taking care of Dad, she didn't look after herself. None of us looked after her, but that's going to change now."
She saw the relief cross Pete's face.
"Dad's still at the hospital with her. I expect Adam will let her come home later today. I need to get things ready for her to make sure she does absolutely nothing when she gets back, doesn't lift one finger, not even if she wants to."
"She's lucky to have you here to take care of her. They both are."
"Thank you for helping us yesterday and for keeping an eye on the shop," Sarah said, struggling to keep her voice polite but impersonal. "You've been a good friend to us, Pete. We appreciate it."
"That was nothing." He paused for a moment and then lifted his eyes to look her full in the face. "Sarah, we need to talk about..." Sarah shook her head.
"No, Pete, not now."
His face fell, but Sarah did not have the emotional strength left to feel anything, and certainly not sympathy for a man who had lied to her. Well, perhaps not lied, but certainly not told her the truth.
There was nothing she could say to him right now, and there was certainly nothing he could say that would change the way she felt. She simply turned and walked into the shop.
She locked the door behind her and turned the hanging sign to say, "closed." Not that she expected customers. Trish Warren would have made certain the whole town knew to stay away from the shop today. For once, she was grateful for the Coorah Creek grapevine. Slowly she walked through the house to be greeted by a loud wail of protest from Megs.